Drawing a pitchfork begins with the identification of 3 points that the price and time position of each of these points directly affect the future behavior of the market. 4 essential parts of every pitchfork are handle, resistance line, support line, and the median line. As mentioned, you can draw Andrews pitchfork by selecting 3 points. These points are among the pivot points on the charts. 4 steps to draw a pitchfork on your chart are as follows. First, select 3 pivots, 1, 2, and 3, that point 1 acts as the base of the pitchfork. Then draw a line from point 2 to 3 and find its midpoint. Connect the line from the base point to the middle point of 2 and 3. This line is called the median line. Then from points 2 and 3, draw 2 lines which are parallel to the median line. We call them upper and lower parallel lines, or as we discussed earlier, resistance and support lines. The same goes for the upward pitchfork. And of course, most trading platforms draw that for you. Before giving practical examples in the field, it's better to get more familiar with different types of chosen points in a pitchfork. You need to make sure that your chosen points are fractals and not just pivots, as they can significantly enhance the credibility of your lines. We will talk about pivots and fractals in detail in a separate video, but in brief, you should know that not every pivot is a fractal, but every fractal is a pivot. Pivot is the place of price rotation. If this rotation leads to a reversal in a major or minor trend, we can consider it as a fractal. Fractals can be identified by 5 particular candles in which the middle candle has the highest high or the lowest low among its 2 consecutive candles before and after it. But pivots are usually made of 3 or 4 candles, and the specifications mentioned for fractals do not apply to them. When the price reaches the median line, it will face one of the following situations. Price bounces back away from the median line, or price crosses the median line and hit the upper or lower parallel line. In this video, you can see that the price is making a V-shaped formation before entering into a consolidation phase. And somehow, it's unable to hit its resistance level. It seems that the market is losing its energy. And then, by creating several powerful bearish candles, it promises further downward movement. In this situation, by selecting the 3 specified fractals on the chart, we draw a standard pitchfork and wait to evaluate the possible price reaction to it. As the market moves forward, the price reaches its median line for the first time and reacts to it with a swift return. Then the market attacks the median line for the 2nd and 3rd time and again fails to cross it. Price tries to attack the median line time and again, but despite all these efforts, it does not succeed in touching the median line and moves towards the upper parallel line. In the first attempt, it fails to reach this line, but the 2nd time it succeeds in doing so. As you can see, the price has moved inside the upper channel of the pitchfork rather than the lower one throughout the entire downtrend. It confirms that the downtrend is weaker than when the price moves in the lower channel of the pitchfork. And when we put this matter alongside the failure of the price to cross the median line, it should give us all a heads up that the market can enter an uptrend by breaking the upper parallel line. Something that finally happened. Using Andrews Pitchfork requires knowing some rules, all of which are derived from the concept of action and reaction in price charts. These rules state that most likely, price reaches its median line 70 to 80% of the time. Price either bounce off, cross with a gap, or fluctuate above and below the median line. When the price crosses the median line, before continuing its route, it returns to the median line and touches it for the last time. When the price reverses before reaching the median line, it creates a much larger movement in the opposite direction by creating an empty space, Hagopian law. Price can also bounce off when dealing with median line images. Here you can see that the price has entered the phase of consolidation in the form of a symmetrical triangle. Therefore, if the price breaks either of the upper or lower sides of the triangle, it can start a strong movement in the same direction. After making sure that a definite break of the triangle to the upward has happened, we can enter a buy position and place our stop loss below the triangle. But the important question that arises here is when should we get out of the trade? Answering this question is crucial because we want to estimate the risk to reward ratio of this trade. For this purpose, we draw a pitchfork by selecting three valid fractals on the chart. Choosing the right fractal comes with experience, but the most important thing is how the price reacts to the pitchfork drawn from those fractals. By drawing a line that has a slope almost the same as the last downward movement of the market and finding its intersection with the median line and knowing that the price most probably reaches this line, we can predict the right exit point, which, as we can see, has a good risk-reward ratio. In the next videos, we will get familiar with other main rules of Andrews Pitchfork and how to use them correctly in price charts. In the end, if this video was useful to you, please support us by pressing the like button. And don't forget to subscribe and press the bell button to be notified of new videos. Till next time.